So I made all these dumb mistakes. Often smile, but they just repeat. It's like a waterfall. Like a waterfall. Hey guys, it's Sweta and welcome to my YouTube channel. So as you can tell by the title of the video, I am going to share a few weight loss tips with you. So a few people requested this video, so that's why I am doing it. And before I start, I just want to say that I am not a nutritionist, a dietitian, or a professional of any sort, and it's obvious, but I am just putting it out there. And also, I know like people requested this video long back, but I was having difficulties recording a video and everything. I just explain it in the end. So if you want to know what happened, just wait till the end. And yeah, now let's just start with the video. So tip number one is to just start slow. So when you are starting out with your health journey or weight loss journey, you might want to start cutting out all the junk food slowly. So let's say if you are having junk food like 4 to 5 times a week, you might want to cut it down day by day rather than just cutting it out all at once. Because if you do cut it out all at once, you'll crave it and you might eat only clean foods for let's say 2 to 3 weeks, but after that you might just break down and start binge eating on all the junk food and just give up like eating healthy foods altogether and go back to where you started. So rather than cutting it out all at once, you might want to just cut it out slowly and also give your body time to adjust to the new things and also try finding healthy foods that you like at the same time. So your body will stop craving all the junk food like as much as it does already. Also, when you're starting exercising or working out, you might want to start with a walk and maybe then start jogging, then start running, rather than saying, okay, I'm just going to start working out tomorrow and I'm going to go on a 5 km run, do thousands, like 100 squats, 100 lunges and 100 crunches. Rather than doing that, you might want to start out with going for walks, then going out for jogs and a few lunges, few crunches and wall push-ups, and then slowly progress over time, and it will definitely give you time to adjust and your body time to adjust to working out and also eating healthy. So that's tip number one. So tip number two is don't follow any crash diets or any crazy diets. I've seen like there are so many crazy diets on the internet and they claim that they can help you lose 10 kgs in 2 weeks. And like losing 10 kgs in 2 weeks definitely doesn't sound very healthy. Like that's a lot of weight to lose in such a short span. Like 10 kgs is a lot and it took me a lot of time to lose just that amount of weight. So you might lose a lot of weight if you do follow these diets, but most of the weight that you first lose when you start with your weight loss journey or health journey is mostly water weight, then you lose the fat. So you might lose a lot of weight, but after that when you go back to eating like healthy and normal amounts of food, you will gain some weight back because you were depriving your body of all the necessary food that it requires to survive. So rather than just cutting out all the necessary food and following a crazy diet, you might just want to start eating healthy foods, eating good carbs, good fats, and obviously proteins. Protein is good for you. It helps you keep the muscle mass on and also lose fat, and it helps you keep fuller for a longer time. So rather than going on a crazy crash diet, just start eating healthy amounts of food and you will definitely see results over time. It might take some time, but it's definitely worth it. So tip number three is do not skip your meals, and I am guilty of this. I know it sounds bad, I have done it, but I don't do it anymore. I did it a few times way back, but I have learned from that. So let's say I wake up and I am hungry, but I just like skipped my breakfast and I waited myself out till lunch, and for lunch I did eat the usual amount that I would eat, but I would also end up overeating, which would just make me feel sick and sluggish. So I just stopped doing it.
I started eating my meals on time. I started having my breakfast, lunch and dinner on time, and it definitely helped. And let's just say, if you go out with your friends on like one day and you have food out, and the next day, rather than just skipping your breakfast to lose some weight, just eat something light and healthy like a smoothie or a toast with egg on it. It's good for you. You won't gain a lot of weight by just having a light breakfast. You might think that it's good that I'm skipping my breakfast to lose weight after having a heavy meal a day prior, but you will just end up starving yourself and eat a lot more than intended for your next meal, like at lunch, and you will gain weight from that, not from eating your breakfast. So rather than just like skipping your meals, just eat them on time. And if you don't feel like you're very hungry for breakfast, just eat something light and healthy and you should be good. So yeah, that's tip number 3. So tip number 4 is to find something that you love. And by saying find something that you love, I mean like I'm talking about both the food and also the exercises and the workouts. So when I first started out with my health journey or weight loss journey, I definitely wasn't eating healthy. I was eating like rice and dal, homemade rice and dal every day. But on top of that, I was also eating all the junk food like chocolates, ice creams, pizzas, burgers, chips, vada pav, dosa, you name it. I was eating it almost every day and it definitely wasn't healthy. So when I first started out, I started cutting out all those like street foods and junk foods, and I had to start incorporating more healthy foods into my diet. So one of the first things that I started eating that can be considered healthy is oatmeal. I used to have savory oatmeal for breakfast, like my mom made it for me every day, and I started eating that. Then I had to find out more things that I love. So I started eating some dark chocolate instead of ice creams and regular milk chocolate. And I also started eating boiled spinach. Like, I've learned to love it now. Like right now, you can give me a cup of boiled spinach and I eat it. I actually like it. So it's just about finding things that you love and that are healthy for you. So definitely start cutting out all the junk foods and start finding things that you love that are healthy for you. So the same goes for your workouts and your exercises. So when I first started out, I started jogging and running on a treadmill that we have at home, and I also started doing Zumba dance. But along the way, I found different things that I like to do. So I found Chloe Ting and Cassie here on YouTube, and they are great YouTubers. So I started doing their workouts and it definitely helped me a lot. I just went from doing just cardio to doing some strength training as well, like basic moves. And after that, I also found out about weight training and like strength training. So I started doing that a little bit. I joined a gym and I did go for about 3 to 4 months, and I was building up some strength. But then the gyms closed down because of the current situation that everyone is in. So I am really excited to go back to the gym after everything is over. So yeah, as I was saying, it's just what you like and just finding things that you like to do. So when you do work out, you are not feeling forced and you just don't force yourself to do it, and it's just a thing to check off your list to lose weight. But it's something that you would love to do and really enjoy doing. So yeah, when you do start working out, just try out different things and find what you love. It might be running, it might be swimming, it might be weight training. It's just all about finding out what you love so you enjoy doing it rather than being forced to do it. So tip number 5 is to count your calories. And I know many people just don't like the whole idea of counting your calories, like they just like to eat intuitively. But counting calories definitely helped me a lot. So when I was first starting out, I actually did not count my calories for a few months. But after that, I learned about a BMR. Like, BMR is basic metabolic rate. It's how many calories your body is burning just existing and not doing anything else. So I learned about that. Then I actually started counting calories to make sure I wasn't overeating and also wasn't under eating, because if I am working out, I want to make sure I am eating enough calories to have energy throughout the day. So that's why I personally started counting my calories. And if you do start counting your calories, it will definitely help you in the beginning. It is very, very helpful to make sure you are not overeating and also not under eating, because when people start with their weight loss journey or health journey, many people cut out lots of food and they are under eating, which isn't good for you. So yeah, just start counting your calories and it will be helpful for you. And rather than looking at it in a negative way, just look at it in a positive way. And yeah, it definitely helps you a lot in the very beginning. After that, you might start understanding how many calories you're eating for every meal without even like having a calorie tracker with you. But in the very beginning, it's definitely helpful. And just don't overdo it, don't be very strict with it. So I definitely am not very strict with like counting my calories. I just count my calories to keep track of what I am eating and making sure I'm not overeating or under eating. So I just use it in that way. And if you are starting out, you might want to start counting your calories to make sure you are not overeating and under eating, and it definitely helped me. So it's just up to you. But I do prefer counting my calories to make sure I'm eating right. So that's tip number 5. So tip number 6 is be consistent. And I can't be stressing it out enough. Just be consistent. You might not see results in the very beginning, but you'll definitely see results in a month or like 2 months if you are working out consistently and eating healthy and good amounts of food. You will definitely see results. And I, as a teenager, tried to lose weight so many times, but I never succeeded because I wasn't consistent every time. So I was like actually 14 or 15 when I, not even 15, I was actually 14 when I first started like dieting and trying to lose weight. So I started out by working out and eating like homemade meals every day, and I did drop a few kgs. But after that, I used to get happy and I just started like I used to start eating all the junk food again, and I used to stop working out. Then I used to gain back all the weight that I had lost and also gain some more. Then I used to start working out again, then gain that weight back and also gain some more. And it was a whole cycle, but in the end I succeeded, because this time around I was consistent and I still am. So for me, it's definitely a lifestyle change. I do eat healthy most of the time, but if I do go out with my friends and family, I have something outside, or if I am craving something, I just eat something sometimes like once a month or like once every 2 months. If I go out with my family, it's more of a lifestyle change for me and not a thing that I am doing for a year or 2 years. And you'll definitely see results if you're consistent with your eating habits and also working out. It will just take some time. It's different for everyone, but rather than giving up, you should just be consistent, and that's when you'll see results and you will be very happy with your results in the end. And I actually saw this comment on my YouTube videos. I'll put it up here if I find it. It like the person said that, oh, it's good that you lost the weight, but I do not support you because you did it just to look beautiful. And I did not know how to respond to the comment. And I just realized that people will talk shit about you anyways. Like when I was fat, people just said, oh, lose the weight, don't eat junk food all the time, don't wear this, don't wear that. And now that I have lost the weight, people are like, okay, good for you, but I don't support you. I just realized that people will just say anything that they want to and they don't care about your feelings. So if you want to lose weight, just go ahead, start eating healthy and start working out. You will definitely see results over time. And I've just learned not to care about people's opinions over the time. I just don't care anymore. People will talk no matter what. And yeah, thank you for listening to my TED talk. Just kidding. And yeah, that's it for the video. But before going, I just want to say something actually. So I do record my videos on my phone camera, and over the past week my phone has just not been working well. It started out with like I couldn't hear the person on the other end of the call, then there were these like yellow spots on my phone screen, and after that it just started shutting off when I was watching a YouTube video, and now it doesn't work well. So I have to change my phone, and I am actually recording this video on my mom's mobile. So I had tried recording this video like in the past week 2 times, but it just did not feel right for some reason. And by the time this week rolled around, my phone's actually kind of dead right now. It's not working properly and I have to change it, and I'm recording this video on my mom's mobile. So I just want to say that I might not be posting videos for the next few weeks. It depends. If I am able to get a new phone, I might post some videos, but I don't feel it's right to just take my mom's or my dad's mobile every time I want to record a video. So yeah, I might not be posting videos for a while, but hopefully you stick around and I'll be back with few more videos in a short time. Like, we'll see when I get my new mobile, if I'm able to get one like during this condition. Yeah, so I just wanted to let you know that. And also, this is it for the video. And also, we are really close to 1,000 subscribers, and I'm very, very excited for that as well. And yeah, that's it for the video. So if you liked it, please leave a like, comment and subscribe to my channel. And also, I'm really excited for the 1,000 subscriber mark, so please consider subscribing. If you do like my videos, if you've watched several of my videos, do consider subscribing. And yeah, that's it for today. So I will see you the next time, hopefully soon. We'll see what's the condition with my mobile. And yeah, that's it for today, and I hope to see you the next time. Bye. So I made all these dumb mistakes, often smile but they just repeat. It's like a waterfall, like a waterfall.